Tired of spending hours analyzing your qualitative data? Imagine uploading your interview transcript and within minutes you get your themes, a summary of your transcript, a report, a code book. What if an AI tool can do it nicely for you without spending a lot of time coding and developing a report? One of the powerful AI tools that is really helping a lot of researchers and students and professionals to make sense of their qualitative data is Ailyze. Ailyze is a qualitative analysis tool that you can use to make sense of your data. But the unique part of Ailyze is that it's using AI to help you to make sense of your data so that you'll be able to finish your data analysis fast. Not only that, so that you'll be able to get quality information from the outcome. So I'm going to do a lot of presentation about Ailyze. So for this one, I'm just going to give you an overview about the main function of Ailyze and then see how you can use to make sense of your qualitative data. So when you go to Ailyze, this is what you see. You can upload more than 50 documents. And then when you upload with the help of AI, you can develop themes or you can generate themes to help you to address your research question. It can also help you to develop a report and a visual representation of your findings. I'm going to put a link in my description so that you can click on it. When you go to the plan, they have a free plan and also the pro plan. The free plan, which where you can also use it to explore the main functions and then see whether it's suitable for your study. I'm going to go through some of the functions that will be very useful for you, right? So imagine that you have collected your qualitative data, right? And you have your transcript. You can upload your transcript and then with the help of AI, you'll be able to do any kind of analysis that you have to do, whether it's thematic analysis, content analysis, discourse analysis, a lot of analysis that you could do, right? You could, if you have it in Excel spreadsheet, open-ended responses with maybe demographic information, yes, you can also upload that information in here. And then with the help of AI, you'll be able to make sense of your data. If you have an audio files, the system can help you to transcribe. If you want to translate, it can translate your transcript or your document. So if you're in a situation where you don't want to actually do the interview, you want AI to help you to do an interview, you can set the system up such a way that AI can interview participants on your behalf. You provide all the questions that you want AI to ask participants and then to be able to interview them and get all the information that you need to make sense of your data. You can also chat with your document using AI chatbot. So there are so many functions here. You know, everything is in one. Everything that you need to help you to finish your qualitative research here, this is the software for you. If you have your transcript and you want to analyze, you can just go to analyze doc or PDF, and then you can create your new project, right? So you go to create new project, and then this one gives you the chance to upload all the transcript that you need to help you to make sense of your data. So you upload all the transcript that, or if you have previous files or transcript, you can also click on use previous, and then you can select the document or the transcript that you want to use, right? And then after selecting or uploading, it will show here the files or the transcript that you have selected. And then you have an option whether you want the system to do a summary for you. If you want to get a summary, you can check that. If you don't want a system to develop themes and create Codebook and also frequency analysis, the system will be able to do that for you. You can check that. If you want to really get access to questions that you want to ask, you can choose that. It can also do frequency analysis for you so that you can get a visual representation concerning the number of files or participants connected to a specific theme or sub-theme. And then you can compare segments. This means that if you have demographic information and you want to compare the kinds of topics or the themes with also demographic like gender or years of experience and all other demographic information, the system can provide you that information. So here you have an option to check what you want a system to do for you. So in this case, I want to develop themes and I have my code book. So I check this one and I go to option instruction. This one, you choose the language that, you know, you want the output of the language to be English. If you're living alone, the language of the output will be the same as the language of the input, which is the interview transcript. So in this case, you leave it alone if you want that to happen, but you can be specific and choose English or choose any language that you want here. And you go to next. Here it's asking you whether you want the AI to generate the themes for you, or you want to create the themes yourself, and you want a system to look for evidence from the data in support of the themes that you have. Especially when you're doing a content analysis, if you have already defined themes or you have already generated your themes and you want a system to go through the data, get evidence and connect them to the theme, you can choose this one. In this case, I just want AI to generate the themes for me. So I choose this one and I click on save and go to next. This is very important. This one, the system want to be sure what kind of data analysis strategy are you going to use. Normally the default is academia and go to thematic analysis. But if you are doing program evaluation, these are the analysis that you can choose from, case study analysis, and also gives you more specific. If you want to be more specific, you can choose that. And it also defines the strategy that you want to use. So you see how this is so customized. It's not just going through the data and developing themes to address your research question. It asks you the kind of analysis that you want the system to do. And we have so many to choose from. This is what makes Ailyze so unique. And then you go to finish. When you click on finish, then the system will go ahead and do the analysis and provide you the report. I will do more videos and give you a detailed steps about what you can do when you have your data. Here is just an overview and I don't want to go into too much detail. The next video I'll touch on each of the function and provide you a demonstration of how to use the function in an efficient way. So the next one I want to also talk about is when you have your Excel spreadsheet, right, with open-ended responses, you can click on this one and upload the data, and then it will ask you a couple of questions, and then after that, it will run and give you the results. So this one is also very useful. I think I've talked about the audio transcription. If you have an audio, you upload the audio and the system can help you to transcribe. Another one is the translation. Let's say you upload a document, right? So when I click on it to go to the place that you already have some document, right? You can upload or you can use previous one. So let me choose one, two, or three. And then I go here and it's asking me what is the original language. The original language is in English. Then what will be the language that you want to translate? I want to translate it to maybe German. And you go to click on submit and the system will be able to provide that to you. So this is a powerful tool. And this tool give you the chance for you to indicate your research question. And then the system will develop themes and sub-themes based on your research question and provide you a report and also the code book. So this one is so powerful. When you click on get data, you can upload all the data that you want to use. You can also put URL here and then the system will be able to help upload the data that you want to use. So when you go to create AI interview, this is where if you want the AI to help you to collect data on your behalf, you can just set it up and provide the system questions that you want the system to ask participants. And then you'll be able to get the link and share the link so that potential participant can click on a link and then start the interviews, right? And so this is all about the main function of Ailyze. Another thing that people are concerned about is data security. So when you click on data security here, it gives you information about how your data is secured, right? So they make sure that your data cannot be reviewed or read or used by any third party, and make sure that your data cannot be used to train their AI tool or their AI model. So your data is very secured when it comes to using Ailyze. Your data is very safe when it comes to using this software. So this is what I have for you. If you want to try it out, go to my description session and then click on the link and then use it. And if you have any question, you can contact me and I'll be happy to address them for you. You can put your question in the comment section. And if you want to have one-on-one consultation how to use this software, I'll be happy to meet you and then have a discussion and show you the best way of using this tool to make sense of your data, right? So I hope this one was helpful. Thank you so much for your time.